We bowl off Metal TV Sports with cricket as the Jamaica Tallawas has re-signed Bangladesh all-rounder Shakib Al Hassan for the upcoming Caribbean Premier League season. Shakib had been part of the franchise in 2016 and 17 before moving to the Barbados Tridents in 2019 and winning the title with them. Meanwhile, Chris Gayle has returned to the St. Kitts and Nevis Patriots. The 41-year-old adds experience and firepower to a Patriots side that had already secured trades for Dwayne Bravo and Sherfane Rutherford from Trinbagonite Riders and Guyana Amazon Warriors, respectively. Gayle was supposed to turn out for the St. Lucia Zooks in the CPL in 2020 after an acrimonious fallout with the Tallawas, but he eventually opted out of last season for personal reasons. The big left-hander had captained the Patriots to their first final back in 2017 when they lost to the Trinbagonite Riders at the Brian Lara Stadium. South African Faf du Plessis, meanwhile, will make a return to the CPL after being snapped up by the St. Lucia Zooks. All squads will be revealed at the CPL draft that will take place tomorrow. The tournament is scheduled to begin on August 28, with the final on September 19, with all games to be played in St. Kitts and Nevis. A physician representing a Japanese medical body today warned that holding the postponed Tokyo Olympics in 2 months could lead to the spread of variants of the novel coronavirus. Dr. Naito Uema, chairman of the Japan Doctors Union, said the International Olympic Committee, IOC, and the Japanese government had underestimated the risks of bringing 15,000 Olympic and Paralympic athletes into the country, joined by tens of thousands of officials, judges, media, and broadcasters from more than 200 countries and territories. The IOC and local organizers say they have been relying on the World Health Organization for public health guidance. They say the Olympics and Paralympics will be safe and secure, focused on extensive testing, strict protocols, social distancing, and keeping athletes largely isolated in the Olympic Village alongside Tokyo Bay. The IOC has said it expects more than 80% of the people living in the village to be vaccinated. This contrasts with a very slow rollout in Japan, where less than 5% of the public has been vaccinated. Uema, who is the chairman of a body that represents 130 physicians, joins other medical experts in Japan in voicing opposition to hold the Olympics. Yesterday, Japan's mass circulation Asahi Shimbun newspaper, which is also a sponsor of the event, called for the Olympics to be cancelled. We kick it over to football news now. Zinedine Zidane has decided to resign as Real Madrid head coach. The Frenchman has called time on his second spell in charge of the La Liga club, who he has led to 2 league titles and 3 consecutive Champions League victories since 2015. His departure comes after Real narrowly lost out on the league titles to City rivals Atletico Madrid on the weekend. Real finished second in La Liga, 2 points behind Atletico, and were knocked out of the Champions League at the semi-final stage by Chelsea and the Copa del Rey in the round of 32 to end the season without a trophy for the first time in 11 years. Finally, in the sports news tonight, Derrick Rose scored 26 points off the bench to lift the host New York Knicks to a 101-92 victory over the Atlanta Hawks in last night's 2 of their NBA Eastern Conference first round games. Now, the win was the first for the Knicks in the playoffs since 2013. Julius Randle recorded 13 of his 15 points in the third quarter and added 12 rebounds for the Knicks, who erased a 15-point deficit to even the best of 7 series at 1 apiece. Game 3 is tomorrow in Atlanta. The Utah Jazz evened their best of 7 Western Conference first-round series against the visiting Memphis Grizzlies with a 141-129 victory in Salt Lake City. Donovan Mitchell returned to the lineup to lead a balanced attack that overpowered a career-best 47-point performance by Ja Morant. Elsewhere, Ben Simmons had 22 points, grabbed 9 rebounds, and dished out 8 assists. Joel Embiid added 22 points and 7 boards. And the host, Philadelphia 76ers, took a 2-0 series lead with a 120-95 victory over the Washington Wizards. Tobias Harris contributed 19 points and 9 rebounds for the top-seeded Sixers. Now, Game 3 will be held on Saturday at Washington. Meanwhile, Wizards superstar Russell Westbrook needed to be restrained after a fan dumped popcorn on his head as he left the floor with an injured ankle. Westbrook exited the game in the fourth quarter after stepping on the foot of 76ers guard Furkan Korkmaz and rolling his ankle. Popcorn was dumped on Westbrook's head as he went through the tunnel, and he had to be restrained by team and Wells Fargo Center security. And those are the stories making sports news tonight. We now head back to the news desk with Shelly Ann Hill.